Hey guys, welcome back! So, this week we'll be looking at my IBM NetVista from 2001 that I recently picked up to be my 90s PC gaming platform. So, let's take a look.
It's not the best looking case, but it isn't the ugliest either. I found this NetVista online and the seller was asking for 25 euros. After some conversation, I was able to bring this baby home for 20 euros. Looking closer, it's a bit cramped on the inside. These desktop cases not always add room for a lot of expansions, but there's more than we need for this purpose. About the specs of this IBM NetVista Type 6793, it has a 2 GHz Pentium 4 processor, 1 GB of RAM, a 30 GB hard disk, a Creative Labs soundboard model CT4810, and NVIDIA GeForce 4 MX440, a very popular AGP graphics card with pretty good graphical performances and was unbeatable on the OEM market. It has 64 megabytes of 128-bit DDR memory, and this P6 IBM motherboard even comes with onboard Ethernet, audio and 4 USB ports. As for the operating system, I opted for the Windows Millennium Edition. The installation went flawlessly and it took about 20 minutes. Windows Millennium Edition is considered to be one of the worst OS ever released, but for now it works just fine. My only concern was to get the sound and graphics working, but Windows installed all the drivers for me. However, I searched online for the latest drivers for the Creative and for the NVIDIA cards. This way, I was sure that everything is updated and probably errors-free. Now, it's time to install some games and see if they work properly. Starting with Indiana Jones and the Infernal Machine, I went for its huge 800 MB install, something that took about 12 minutes. Let's try it and see if it works. I remember that back in 1999, it was a demanding game, graphically speaking. Let's turn up the volume a bit.
Thank you. time to go to work.
Next up, Grand Prix Legends from 1998. It's one of the greatest sim racing games ever made. Seems that all is working just fine. Here's a game that I've never played. This is Alien Nations from Joe Wood. These guys were best known for their amazing rally trophy. Well, now that it's installed, I'll probably make a review in the near future.
Mystery Life. Mystery Evolution. After all, the answer is so simple. New life is the...
To finish this special video, let's try Motocross Madness 2 from 2000 and see if it has any problem. As you can see, it all seems to run really smoothly, no graphical or sound issues of any kind. So guys, here's my rig for those games from mid and late 90s and also early 2000s. It's a pretty good system so far. I will install more games and see if they run smoothly and without any kind of problems. Thank you very much for watching and I'll see you guys later this week.